Oh. Is he back?
Here he is.
Hey!
I'm trying to
So we're on a walk and my heel came off my shoe, believe it or not, and I fell over and nearly went under this lorry. He thought it was funny. And on the same walk, I bought a new pair of shoes, and that was even funnier.
Got a video of it as well. Oh, God. I haven't got any way to play it.
Yeah.
All right. Well,
sorry. So the walks?
Yeah, I've chosen not to reveal any of the content from the majority of those walks, so they're all just that. Particular moral reasons. The Paul's lived a pretty colourful life prior to me knowing him. Even from birth, he's actually born in an RAF camp in Singapore. Hopefully not everyone knows, that's a bit of a fact. He's attended work conferences in Vegas, more than one. Conducted dodgy business deals on golf courses, once attempted to break into a career in acting, applied numerous times to be on The Apprentice. Followed by a full night out where we're ending up in the bar at 6 a.m. to watch Floyd Mayweather fight Conor McGregor.
Absolutely. We're all asleep at all. You missed that bit.
Not yet. Thanks for ruining
it. I'm sorry.
Suspense. We were up against it that night because the aircon broke in the bar. It was boiling from the amount of people gathered there. The fight went a full 12 rounds, Steve.
That wasn't the fight on the telly, that was us and some of the guys. That's another story.
So I'll mention Sangu after that. I think we got back to the apartment around 9 a.m, which gave us half an hour to have a rest before we needed to pack our bags and check out. On top of that, our flight wasn't until late afternoon, so the seven of us spent the whole day wandering around Prague, powering ourselves through our sleep deprivation and signs of building. It's been nice to get to know Paula over the years too, and I'm sure that a lot of Paula's positive attitude can influence by now. You can't be a good positive than someone who spent their life nursing people back to health and encouraging children to be inquisitive and learn. I'd often hurriedly walk down to her house and do my holiday, hassled about being made by Paul, to find him sitting at the dining room table with headphones on, fully engrossed in the game of Round to a War. He then still has to have a shower and get ready to go out, so this was the main time that I got to know Paula, because she'd been left to entertain me. She's a great host, though, always very welcoming and with a beer in hand. We discussed a lot, and she's always given me good advice. There's quite a lot that I've had to omit from this speech, such as the recent Sangdi in London. But we've had some great fun over the years. It was always ambitious inviting 50 people, who were mostly strangers, to the capital for a session. All dead. But one person even came from Amsterdam. The key thing is that so many people wanted to celebrate such a big moment in Paul's life for them, which is great. I think that's relatively pain-free.
Brilliant.
No, not almost. Nothing was too embarrassing. It's not like you've ever drunkenly had a tattoo saying bad boy in your ass or anything. On that note, I'd like you all to join me in raising a toast to the writing room.